Welcome back to Terpy Eyes. I'm Ryan, and this is the second video in this series that is sponsored by Viper Spectra. In the first video, we unbox and set up our complete grow tent setup, where we are using the Viper Spectra KS2500 LED grow light in a 3x3 grow tent. Although the KS2500 light is now discontinued, Viper Spectra offers many different sizes and models to fit different grow spaces and setups. I recommend using the KS3000 LED light in a 3x3 space, which we have used on the channel in the past. Viper Spectra did provide the discount code TerpyEyes that can be used on their website for any of the products that they offer, so be sure to check them out after this video. All links to brands and products used in this video will be in the video description below. We'll be growing the strain Alien Rift from ocean grown seeds. These are regular photoperiod seeds, and we start them off by soaking the seeds in bottled water for anywhere between 24 and 48 hours, or until the seeds have popped open, showing a small taproot. Once the seeds have popped open, we can then place the seeds in a small starter pot, which we are using 3.5 inch by 3.5 inch thin wall pots. If you're growing autoflowers, you'll want to put your seeds into their final pot size right away instead of transplanting up as they grow. We filled the starter pots using Promix HP as the growing medium, which is a peat-based growing medium and has no nutrients in it for the plants to live off of. So we'll be watering each pot with a Clonex clone solution mixed into water at a rate of 6 milliliters per liter of water. We are giving each of the pots approximately 30 milliliters of that mix as an initial amount to rehydrate the growing medium before we make a small shallow hole in each of the pots for a seed to be placed into. As we place a seed into each of those holes, we lightly cover the hole just enough so no light and direct airflow can reach the seed. This will give the best results for success. One thing I noticed while making this video is that I missed one of the pots when making the small holes, which meant I also didn't put a seed into that location, which explains why a plant never ended up growing in that location at all. And for the other reason, I had an extra seed at the end of it, so I ended up adding another pot into the grow tent. I did think that was kind of odd while doing the work, but just thought maybe I miscounted the seeds, which wasn't the case after all. After all the seeds have been covered, we put another 30 milliliters of Clonex clone solution mix into each of the pots, but keeping it to the outer portions of the pot, which avoids the water from disturbing the placement of the seed in the growing medium. I'd also recommend watering each of the pots slightly more than what I did in this grow, which will keep the growing medium moist a little longer, but be sure not to go overboard, as you do want the growing medium to dry out within a week to keep the root system healthy. I ended up missing the first week of growth for this grow due to a malfunction of the GoPro camera, but we can now see that all the seeds ended up making it out of the growing medium, leaving us with 12 small seedling plants, and we also see the location I missed while putting the seeds into the pot. We did have a couple points where the seedlings drooped down a bit due to underwatering from letting the growing medium dry out a bit too much. Alright guys, so we're over here at the Alien Rift tent. These are regular seeds. So we got 12 seeds that germinated and popped out of the growing medium. So we have one that didn't pop out, so we won't need to sex test that. But we're going to sex test these instead of letting them grow out into full-size plants and then determining the sex. So we got our sex testing kit here from Farmer Freeman. They also offer virus testing right here, so if you have Hops latent viroid and these other ones, you can send in your testing parameters for that if you need to check that. So for our sex testing, all we need to do, since I'm in Canada and they are in the States, to ship these through the border, like have to mail them in to get the testing done, we have these smash cards. So this is just a clear piece of plastic and a piece of paper here. So all we need to do is whatever plant we're sex testing, we're gonna cut the tip of the plant off of a leaf. So now we have our leaf here. I like to ball these up so I get the most juice out of them. And then we're gonna put the plant material in between the clear and the paper right there. See how it's sandwiched in? And then all I'm going to do is use the back of my scissors, so lock those in, so I have the blunt end of this. And I'm just gonna place this on the table and smash this until all the juices come out of the plant material. Okay, so I smashed that in. As you can see, it is pretty smushed now. But if you flip this over onto the backside, you're gonna want to see that the moisture has gone all the way through the paper. This is very important for them to do the testing properly. So there we go. We've got one plant done, which is this one right here. So we'll open up the sex testing kit on the back. There is a number and a strain. So you'll write your strain name or whatever plant that is that you got. And inside the envelope, you have a plant tag. Just confirm that the two numbers match, which they do. So I'll stick this plant tag right into that pot. So we have that labeled. And then inside, there's nothing else. And then we'll take our smashed leaf that we got, put that into there, and just close it. Use the green sticker to seal it closed. There's no need to use the actual adhesive on the envelope. Just use the sticker, firm and close that, and then we're good to go. We can move on to the other ones. As we wait for the results to come back from Farmer Freeman, the plants got about one more week worth of growth in those small pots, which put them pretty much at their maximum size before they would have started slowing down their growth due to running out of space for the root system to grow into. Overall, the small plants stayed decently healthy over those early stages of growth, even considering the few times where we had the growing medium dry out a bit too much. Don't forget, if you're enjoying the video so far or found it at all helpful, to hit that like button. It really goes a long way in supporting the channel and helping us grow. Up until this point, all we were doing was feeding the plants the CloneX clone solution, but they are more than ready to start receiving real nutrients, which we'll be using the front row egg nutrients once we finish the transplanting into larger pots. We got our sex testing done from Farmer Freeman. We just got our results in. So here's the printout of the email that they send us. Each tag, see this tag, represents one of the ones right here. So see, we have a male right there. So I've already gone ahead and identified the males and females out of these ones. So I'm just gonna confirm as I remove each plant with this piece of paper. So we can transplant the females into 1 gallon pots, or maybe even 3 gallon pots. We'll see how it goes. So we'll break apart all these plants. So this, no plant here, just move that to the side. And we had a pretty terrible male to female ratios for this one. So 74, which we've already looked at, this is a male. We'll put the males back here. Then this is 57. This is a female. So we'll put the females back here. This is another female. As you can see, these are to the left of the pot. At the front, those are all males. And then when I identified them, I put a female at the back left. Sometimes these pots are hard to get apart from each other. So here's another female. We ended up with only 4 females out of this batch of seeds, which is pretty disappointing given that we had so many seeds that popped, and these are pretty overall like decent health plants. I'm pretty happy with these ones, but unfortunately all these are male. So we'll just have to get rid of that. Eight plants that are male. So we'll move that out of the way. And here are our final 4 females. We are now at day 28 from seed, and since we did determine which plants were female and which ones were male, we can transplant those female plants into larger pots and save material that would have been wasted if we had to grow out those male plants while waiting for them to show sex naturally. We are transplanting up into 3-gallon pots, as these will be our final pot size, and continuing to use the Promex HP as the growing medium. Since the small plants grew a little slower than normal, it ended up being the perfect time to transplant before they started slowing down from becoming root bound. Normally, I would have liked to top the plants anywhere between day 18 and day 25, or during the transplanting. But for this grow, we decided to keep things very simple to see the results from an untopped plant. The plants received their first feeding of real nutrients at this point, where we gave each of the plants 2 liters of front row egg nutrients while following their recommended feeding chart found on the front row egg website. Front row also provided the discount code TERPYEYES to receive 40% off your entire order for any of the products that they offer. While watering each of the plants, I like to give 1 liter of nutrient mix, then wait a few minutes before giving the second 1 liter feeding, since the Promex HP is pretty dry from sitting around for a while, so there is a chance that the nutrient mix would just run out the bottom of the pots if given a large amount all at once. We are going to end this episode here. So if you've made it to the end of the video, you're the real MVP, and thank you so much for the support. And I can't wait to show you what I have planned for our new content coming up next month. So until next time, happy growing, everyone. And remember to get out there and make it happen.